Alright everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So today I want to try mining some iron. Now, of course, the first thing I've got to do is find some iron ore. Now, most people think of iron ore as a reddish brown, rusty like rock. Well, that's true about the banded iron deposit, but around here in the middle of Utah, you don't find that very often. In fact, the most iron rich rock I know of is right here that I'm standing on. So point down here. This is actually a fairly common rock in the area, but this is the only place I know where it outcrops. Let's break off a chunk of this. So you can see it's white and a little bit gray. So there's not any obvious reddish brown coloring to it, but if you bring a magnet next to it, it sticks to a magnet. What you basically got is the white silica rich rock with little specks of magnetite in it. Magnetite is of course black and very magnetic. So this rock right here will be our iron ore, which I'll try to extract iron from. So to get the magnetite grains out of the rock, the obvious answer is that I need to crush the rock into a powder and sift them out. But I'm sort of lazy, and if I don't have to, I'd prefer not to spend all day crushing rocks. So we've just come down the hill a little bit into this area where you've got some eroded alluvium here. And this is the same type of rock, but Mother Nature has done all the work of crushing it up. So all I've got to do is screen it out a little bit, use the gravity separation to extract the magnetite. That right there is going to have a lot of iron. We're back closer to home. I've got my mom's flour sifter here, and I'm just going to sift out the larger bits of rock. They still have a lot of iron in them, but they've also got a lot of silica that I'd have to get rid of, so we're just going to toss those away. Get those out. I want the tiny pieces of magnetite that are just on their own. You know, now that I got it like this, I might actually be able to pull out iron with the magnet. Picks up a lot of dirt with it though, so I think we're just going to continue with the washing idea. So now get it all wet. Get into a nice slurry. Now the heavy magnetite will sink to the bottom, whereas the lighter silicate richness stuff will just kind of float over the side. So you can see the iron poking through now. Look at that. Isn't that lovely? That's what you get from digging into the bottom of an old stream that's flowing through iron rich rock.
Is that the same as the black sand that you get when you're panning?
Yeah. The black sand's usually a mixture of hematite and magnetite. This is probably mostly magnetite, though, just because of the rocks it's from. I'll tell you what, let's spread it out underneath of water and use the magnet now. It's a way to purify it without getting too much of the dirt stuck to it. You can see now it's just got a bunch of tan mud. A little bit of black specks left over. The hematite really isn't all that much magnetic. So now I need something for the iron oxide to react with to give its oxygen away to form iron metal. Now that would be a thermite reaction if I were to use aluminum, but carbon is far easier to get and far cheaper. Plus the reaction won't be quite so vigorous. So this here is some partially burned coal from our household fireplace, and this is essentially coke, which is what they use industrially. So I'll just get a couple of pieces of this here, and we'll break them up a little bit, but that'll be our carbon source, our reducing agent. So now for flux, we need some limestone. I got a large chunk of limestone right here. You can see the little animal shells in it. Those are calcium carbonate, which will react in the furnace to create calcium oxide, which will make an excellent high temperature flux for the iron, keep it from further oxidizing due to the air. We probably don't need much. So here's our limestone, which I'm just gonna crush up using my little pestle and mortar. Okay, there's that. Now let's crush up the impure carbon coke. I could probably also use charcoal. It's basically the same thing. Okay, that's actually probably all I need right there. Let me get rid of the rest of this. Don't need it. So there's our iron recipe. Magnetite, crushed limestone, a little bit of carbon. Just get these mixed together. It's gonna be a little wet at first, but the furnace will dry it out no problem. Just to cheat a little bit and make things easier for myself, I'm gonna add in a little bit of soda ash. This'll help react with any residual silica that may be there. Make it more fluid, basically turn it to glass. I never could get my homemade furnace working. I may come back to this, but for now, I've got an induction furnace to play with. See, this thing has a very high frequency magnetic field switching, which is very powerful. And that causes an eddy current in the metal. It's basically like a short circuit in a transformer. And that'll cause it to heat up. That ought to melt steel. So let's put our stuff right in here. Just like this. Pour that stuff in there. Alright, looks like just about right for this size crucible. Let's get the big generator going. Let's heat that up. Here's the data plate. You see it's a 20 kilowatt generator. It's up to 62.7 amps on multiple phases. Alright, we got our cooling water spilling out. Let's turn this on. Okay, so we got 260 amps oscillating at almost 100,000 times a second. This thing will get warm real quick. There we go, it's getting red hot. It'll be white hot by the time we're done. Now we're cooking. You can see the carbon dioxide coming out as the iron oxide is reacting with the carbon. So it is making iron metal. Question is, will it be liquid or will it be a bloom? Maybe if I poke out a little bit and stir it, I can get the metal to come together into a single glob. I'm just worried that it's going to be dissolving away my graphite crucible. Do I still have a nail? Yeah. So, I don't think it's melted the metal yet, but I think I have got it to come together and there's like a solid chunk of iron in there. I can feel something solid. Well, let's let it get a little hotter, maybe it'll melt. Oh, I wasn't recording. Okay, try again. Look at that, you can actually see shiny metal down in there. That almost looks like silver melting. But I know it's iron. I think it's melted. Did it melt your nail?
It's starting to. The nail's still there, but it was trying to melt it.
There's a blob of metal on the side of it.
Yeah, there's your metal right there.
Is it welded to it?
Yeah, it's welded to it.
Separate from the slag.
Can you tilt it into the sunshine?
Yeah.
There we go.
Yeah, you got some glass on top of it there.
Okay.
Now I'll find out if you have metal. Alright. Something broke out. I want to get out of the sun so we can see. Oh yeah, you got metal there. Add a lump of iron. It's probably cast iron because of all the carbon.
Look at that.
That's out of the ground. Oh, there's a piece. Oh, it's warm. Yeah, it's definitely brittle.
Hey, Cody, what just happened there?
magnet stuck to the anvil. Got it. Okay. Let's see. Has any of these cooled off? A little bit. It's iron. There we go. We made iron from a rock. Yeah, so, yeah, it breaks. That's about like cast iron, so it wouldn't make a very good knife, would it?
Not until you worked it a little bit.
Yeah, no. I guess you could blow oxygen through it like the Bessemer steel process and make it into steel. Because right now it's just iron. There you go. Hope y'all enjoyed. I'll see you next time. All right, looks like there's some like tape or something. Let's see if I can get that undone.